nation, a great gift to those who understand its user manual, its ups and downs. Imagination brings words on a page into the minds of its readers, creating nights to illuminate the monsters under your bed, an extension of your body, an immortal world where your out-of-place self can feel at home, where you can be or do whatever you want. This continues nothing, but with every strength comes weakness, and fear stops imagination from flourishing. I fear many things, the dark that sometimes takes over my thoughts, the isolation separating me from the flow, the fear that sometimes I've gone too far. Fear, the enemy of imagination. People can manipulate you using your fear in them, something I've seen in many books, but is it really just in books? Fear is all around us. Leaders use your fear to follow the rules, stay between the lines. It's what keeps us in the box. But imagination and creativity can build you a ladder. Imagination comes with a sword that saved you from monsters, but it can also be held against you.
Yes.
It can weaken the heart that was taught to be strong, but what does confidence do against sharp objects?
Yeah.
I see things best left unseen, but my hope guides me through the foggy forest of life. Hope, it's imagination mixing with memories and those around me. Others can influence your imagination. Some call them authors, songwriters, journalists, painters, dancers, actors, poets. But they have one thing in common, the power to influence. Hopes, fears, and dreams make a person. But in a world of limits, it's easy to forget the limitless. We don't think to imagine. The things that make life most worth living were made by surpassing the limit we were told to stay within. They say the air gets too thin if we soar too high, but I'm telling you to push your lungs, fill them with new air and opportunity.
Woo.
Tell your fear to go back down to the surface where it belongs,
yes.
So you can climb on top of it and reach new heights. Imagination,